Good morning, students. So in this session we'll be discussing about the last gas law of this chapter, that is Dalton's law of partial pressure, and it is given by, put forth by John Dalton. So before going to what does this law state, that is the statement of law, let us take an illustration about this law and then we'll be knowing what is the statement of this law. So take a chamber or take a box which has two gases in it. The one gas is, say, hydrogen gas, the other one is a helium gas. So it's an hydrogen gas, both are gases, and this is helium gas. The volume of the container that you have taken, the volume of the box, say it is V, say VML or VCM cube, etc. So volume of this chamber is VML. As a result, the hydrogen gas volume is also VML and helium gas volume is also VML. That is because we have studied that in gaseous state, that is the gases occupy the volume of the container, that is the volume of the gas is equal to the volume of the container. Andre, ee hydrogen gas na if I release into this box, it takes the total volume, the whole volume of this box. As well helium moisture, if I release into this box, it takes the volume of this box. Hagagi, if the volume of this box is VML, hydrogen gas the volume uno VML, helium gas the volume uno VML. And the temperature is T anta tagolana. And the temperature is taken to be T. So this hydrogen gas molecules or helium gas molecules, they travel continuously, that is they wander continuously inside this box. Sumne kootirodilla hydrogen molecules agirbodu athwa helium molecules agirbodu, they do not sit simply, they wander all along the box. Eshtu volume idu total volume ashtukunu they will be keeping wandering, andre movement irutte. As a result they collide to the container's wall. Yen container idyo a container ina walls ge they will be hitting continuously. As a result, there is a pressure created inside this box. This box will get a pressure create. So that pressure, if I take it as Pt, if I take it as pressure Pt, that is equal to the pressure created due to hydrogen gas plus the pressure created due to helium gas. And right? Hydrogen molecules agirbodu athwa helium molecules agirbodu, they keep wandering inside the box. So during this wandering, they hit the walls of the container. So as a result, there is a pressure created, and that pressure is Pt anta tagondre. That is the pressure of this, that is the pressure created inside this box anta tagondre. That will be equal to the pressure created due to hydrogen gas, hitting of hydrogen gas molecules to the walls, plus the pressure created by the helium atoms to the container walls. So this is the Dalton's law of partial pressure, that is it tells that at constant temperature for a fixed volume the total pressure created by a non-reacting mixture of gases, and then the gases which we take inside this container should not react with each other. Andre hydrogen matte helium, they do not react with each other. Ondukondu react agala. Adhe nan hydrogen gas chlorine gas tagondidre, they react at room temperature and it forms HCl. Hydrogen chloride bandbidtittu. Hagagi ee container velgade nan en tagobeku, non reacting gaseous mixture tagobeku. Andre aa gases madhya there should be no reaction. So non reacting gaseous mixture tagondaga, the total pressure created due to the mixture of gases, that is each gas exerts some pressure, the total pressure is equal to, idu nen karithini small p nal barthidina, that is called as the partial pressures anta karithini. They are called as the partial pressures due to each gases, or it is called as the sum of the partial pressures of the each gases. So let us see the statement. So the statement goes like this: the total pressure exerted by mixture of non-reacting gases andre adu ondukondu react agabodu, as your hydrogen and helium, they do not react with each other. Adrudu total pressure Pt is equal to the sum of the partial pressures exerted by each individual gas. It is the sum of the partial pressure, that is the pressure exerted by hydrogen gas individually plus pressure exerted by helium gas. So it is equal to the sum of the partial pressures exerted by each individual gas at constant temperature and volume. So that is PT is equal to partial pressure of hydrogen gas plus partial pressure of helium gas at this instance. In general, I can write it as this equation as PT is equal to partial pressure of first gas, partial pressure of second gas, partial pressure of third gas, etc. So how many number of gases? It is the sum of the partial pressure of each individual gas at constant temperature and volume. So PT is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. So that's the general equation for your Dalton's law of partial pressures. The next thing we have to discuss is how to calculate this individual partial pressure. On the individual partial pressure, na hey calculate madado from your Dalton's law of partial pressure. So let us take an illustration here. So I have a box, a container, where there are two gases, say gas 1 and gas 2. Again, there are two gases in this container. It is gas 1 and gas 2. The gas 1, number of moles of gas 1 is say N1. And number of moles of gas 2 is say N2. N2 is the number of moles of gas 2. N1 is the number of moles of gas 1. At a constant volume, that is the total volume V anta tagondre, gas 1 volume V agate, gas 2 volume V agate. That is because any gas takes the volume of its container. Or container the volume enirutho, that will be the volume of any gas. Hagagi V is the volume anta tagondre, gas 1 the volume V, gas 2 the volume V. At a constant temperature tagondre, it is T. T is the temperature. So for this illustration, if I apply your ideal gas equation, apply madadre, say for gas 1, yen agate, P1 is the partial pressure of gas 1 into V. Ili V1 illa because gas 1 do volume V ne, gas 2 do volume no V ne. So P1 into V is equal to N1. What is N1? N1 is the number of moles of gas 1 into RT. R is a constant. Hagagi R is just remaining as R. T is a constant. T is also a constant. Hagagi T. So this is for gas 1. Aditra gas 2 tavandre. P2 into V is equal to N2 into RT. So that's your ideal gas equation for gas 2. That's your ideal gas equation for gas 2. We know that ithane Dalton's law lo didivi. PT is equal to P1 plus P2. That is the total pressure of this container. It is equal to the partial pressures of gas 1 and partial pressure of gas 2. Sum of partial pressure of gas 1 and partial pressure of gas 2. So how can I write this as P1? Heng bari bodondre? P1 is equal to N1 RT by V. P2 heg bari bodu, P2 is equal to N2 RT by V. Very simple, you are equating this equation for P1. N madbeku, V na denominator kalsbeku. E equation no P2 ge equate madbeku, E V na denominator kalsbeku. N agate equation, this becomes PT is equal to N1 RT divided by V plus N2 RT divided by V. You have a common factor RT by V. RT by V common factor de, adana hache tegadre, it becomes PT is equal to N1 plus N2 into RT by V. That's the common factor in these two things. So hagage RT by V na common tegidini. I'll take this as equation 3. So if I want to calculate the partial pressure of gas 1 anta ankonana, I want to calculate the partial pressure of gas 1. What is that? P1. That's the partial pressure of gas 1. So hagagi I divide it by PT. P1 by PT. I am calculating the partial pressure of gas 1. So hence I have taken P1 by PT. So what is P1? P1 enu gottu. P1 is N1 RT by V. So this is N1 RT by V.
whole divided by
PT. What is PT? N1 plus N2 into RT by V.
So this is N1 plus N2 into RT by V.
RT by V, RT by V cancel out. As a result, this becomes
P1 divided by PT is equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2.
ಈ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಮ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಒನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನೆನಪಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಏನದು? ಎನ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎನ್ ಟೂ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ನೆನಪಿದ್ಯಾ? ಎಸ್. ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ನೋಡಿದಿರಾ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಾ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಎನ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎನ್ ಟೂ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಒನ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಒನ್. So I can write this as equal to chi 1. That I can write it as chi 1. What is chi 1? It's the mole fraction of gas 1. By rearranging this equation, yen beku namge equation inda, we want the partial pressure of gas 1. Hagagi P1 ge equate madidre yenagutte equation? P1 is equal to, what is P1? P1 is the partial pressure of gas 1. That is equal to chi 1. What is chi 1? Chi 1 is mole fraction of gas 1 into PT. So PT nen madidini, I have sent it to numerator. Ikade kalisidini. Since I am equating for equation 1, this becomes P1 is equal to chi 1 into PT. Adhe tara P2 beku andre, P2 is equal to chi 2 into PT. So like this, you can identify the partial pressure of each individual gas by knowing its mole fraction as well as the total pressure of the container. Total pressure of the container gotidre, you can calculate the partial pressure of each gas, and vice versa, partial pressure gotidre, you can calculate the PT. PT is nothing but the sum of partial pressure of each gases. Hagagi vice versa, ee mooru factors alli yadadru erdu factor gotidre innond factor na easy agi identify maadabodu. So this is how you identify the partial pressure of each gas in a mixture of non-reacting gases. So these two equations are very important. This same equation na second PUC nallunuve neevu solutions anno chapter li kalithira. It is continued till your next year, that is solutions chapter, the same equation ide. So it's a very important equation, very important equation that will be carried over to your second PUC also. So this is how you find out the partial pressure of an individual gas if you have a mixture of gases. The next thing is, if you have a gas which has some moisture content, which have some moisture content, how to calculate its partial pressure from that gas? That is, yavadadru ondu gas iddu adralli solpa moisture content idre, how to calculate the partial pressure of that dry gas? Dry gas ana partial pressure hege calculate madodu adana ig nodana. ಸೊ ಏನಿದೆ ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ, ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಏರನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ತೀರ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ಅ ವಾಟರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಒಂದು ವಾಟರ್ ಇರುವಂಥ ಪ್ಲೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ವಾಟರ್ ಬಂಡ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಓಡಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬ್ರೀಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ದರ್. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬೀಸೋ ಗಾಳಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರುವಾಗ ಆ ಗಾಳಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ನೀರಿನ ಕೆಲವು ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ವಾಟರ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ನ ಪಿಕಪ್ ಮಾಡಿರುತ್ತೆ, ವಾಟರ್ ವೇಪರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಆ ವಾಟರ್ ವೇಪರ್ಸ್ ಇರುವಂಥ ಏರು ಇಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ಸ್ ಯು, ಇಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್. ಅದೇ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಡೆಸರ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಡ್ರೈ ಪ್ಲೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋದರೆ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎನ್ ಹಾಟ್ ಏರ್. ಅಂದರೆ ದ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಏರ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಾಟರ್ ವೆನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಲೇಡನ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಏರ್ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ರೈ, ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಮಾಯಿಶ್ಚರ್ ಪಿಕ್ಡಪ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಿನ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಗ್ಯಾಸಿನ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂತ ನಾವಿವಾಗ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಆಗಲೇ ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ, ಸೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆ ವಾಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ವಾಟರ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ರಿವರ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಈ ವಾಟರ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ, ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಏರ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಏರ್, ಸೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟರ್. ವಾಟರ್, this air is not dry, it is a moisture laden air anta helbodu. It has some moisture content. Moisture andre you have some water vapors in it, water vapors plus air. So ee air du it is PT, that is the total pressure created by this air, it is equal to the partial pressure of dry gas plus the partial pressure of water vapors. That is because water vapors is again the gaseous form of your water. Hagagi ee moisture laden air enidiyo illi aa air the total pressure tagondre athwa pressure calculate madidre it is the sum of partial pressures of dry gas, dry air anta bekaru tagobodu, plus it is the partial pressure due to the water vapors. ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ನನಗೆ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಏರ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಏರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟೋಟಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಪಿ ಟಿ ಮೈನಸ್ ಈ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇಪರ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಏನಿದೆಯೋ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ವಾಟರ್ ವೇಪರ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯೋ ಅದನ್ನು ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಏಕ್ವಿಯಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಆಫ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಏರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಡ್ರೈ ಏರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು PT, that is the total pressure, minus e partial pressure due to water vapors in create agidiyo, that is called as your aqueous tension. So like this you can calculate the partial pressure of a dry gas from a moisten laden air. Now let us look into some of the numericals based upon how to calculate the partial pressure of an individual gas by using the equation partial pressure is equal to mole fraction into PT, that is total pressure. ನಾನು ಏನು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟೂ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ನೋ ಅದ್ರ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಾಲ್ಟನ್ಸ್ ಲಾ ಮೇಲೆ ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಸಮ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲುಕ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಅ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಡೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಡೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಓ ಟು, ಡೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಓ ಟು. ಅ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಡೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಚರ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ 70.6 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಡೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 167.5 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್. ಸೊ they have given the mass of oxygen taken, mass of that gas taken, oxygen gas 70.6 grams, and mass of neon taken it is 167.5 grams of neon. So that's the mixture of gas in the cylinder. If the pressure of the mixture of gases in the cylinder, that is nothing but the pressure of the cylinder, is 25 bar, it is 25 bar andre PT aitu, it is the total pressure inside that cylinder, it is equal to 25 bar. That is, it is the pressure due to oxygen gas as well as neon gas. You know that both oxygen neon are non-reacting gases. What is the partial pressure of oxygen gas and neon gas? Erdudu partial pressure calculate madbeku in the mixture. Mixture alli partial pressure of oxygen gas eshtu, partial pressure of neon gas eshtu anta calculate madbeku. They have given the PT. ಸೊ ಏನೇನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಗಿವನ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಾದ್ರೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್? ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಪಿ ಟಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಪಿ ಟಿ ಎಸ್ 25 ಬಾರ್. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಿ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್, ಮಾಸಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ 70.6 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ 167.5 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್. ವಿ ನೋ ದಿ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ partial pressure of your oxygen gas is equal to mole fraction of oxygen gas into PT. So all tagondiddi P1 is equal to chi1 into PT anta, aa 1 badle illi oxygen direct aagi tagondiddini. So partial pressure of oxygen gas is equal to mole fraction of oxygen gas into PT. Adhe tara partial pressure of neon gas is equal to mole fraction of neon gas into PT. ಇದೆರಡು ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ಸ್ ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಪಾರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ನಾವೇ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ನಿಯಾನ್ದು ನಾವೇ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಪಿ ಟಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್, ಪಿ ಟಿ ಎಸ್ 25 ಬಾರ್. ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗಿವನ್, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್. ಸೊ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಈಕ್ವೇಷನು? ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು number of moles of oxygen divided by number of moles of oxygen plus number of moles of neon, n1 divided by n1 plus n2. mole fraction of neon calculate madak equation eno, number of moles of neon divided by number of moles of oxygen plus number of moles of neon, that is the total number of moles of gaseous particles. ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ 1- ಅಂತ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಬೋದು. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್. ಅಥವಾ ಎರಡಕ್ಕೂ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಬೇಕಾದರೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಯಾಕೆ ಹಾಗಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂದರೆ, ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಅಂತ ಓದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಅಂತ ಓದಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ಚರ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1 ಅಂತ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇದೆರಡರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು 1 ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದಕ್ಕೆ 1- ದ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಈಗ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಯಾನಿಗೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 1- ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಅಂತ ಬೇಕಾದರೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಅದು ಮಾಡಿ ನಾನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀನಿ, ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್. ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಥರ ಬೇಕಾದರೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಬೇಕು, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಬೇಕು. ಏನಕ್ಕೆ? ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರಾ? ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಗಿವನ್? ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ. ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮಾಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮಾಸ್ ಇಂದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ? ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್. ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಎಸ್, ನಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತು. ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾ? ಗೊತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಏನು? ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್. ಮಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ದು? 70.6 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 70.6 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಎಷ್ಟು? ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ 16, ಡೈ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ 16 × 2 ಎಷ್ಟು? 32. ಸೊ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ 32 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 32. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2.21 ಮೋಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇನ್ 70.6 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ 2.21 ಮೋಲ್ಸ್. ಅದೇ ಥರ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾಸ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು? ಮಾಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ 167.5 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ನೋಬಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಅದು ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ ನೋಬಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅದರ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸೇ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮಾಸು. ಸೊ ನಿಯಾನ್ದು ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 20. ಸೊ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 8.375 ಮೋಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ 167.5 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 8.375 ಮೋಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನಮಗೆ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ದು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ತು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ದು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸು ಸಿಕ್ತು. ನಾವು ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ದು ನಮ್ಮ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್. ಸೊ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು. ಸೊ ಈಗ ತಾನೇ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ 2.21 ಮೋಲ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ 70.6 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 2.21 ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ದು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ 8.375. ಸೊ 2.21 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 2.21 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 8.375, ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 0.21. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್, 0.21. ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಯೂನಿಟ್, ಯಾವುದೇ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಸ್ 0.21. ನಾವು ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್. ನಿಯಾನ್ದು ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಈ ಥರ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಎಷ್ಟು? 8.375 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಯೋರ್ 2.21 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 8.375. ಹಾಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದರೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾನ ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬೋದು. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಯಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು
1 minus mole fraction of oxygen.
Oxygen already calculate maadidini.
That is equal to 1 minus 0.21. So that's equal to 0.79 is the mole fraction of your neon.
Hang calculate maadidru andre complete formula hakon calculate maadidru you get this 0.79 mole fraction. Athwa simple aagi calculate maadodakke you can use this formula because mole fraction of constituent particles, sum of mole fraction of constituent particles is always equal to 1. So, hagagi mole fraction of neon direct aag tagondidini 1 minus mole fraction of oxygen. So, that's equal to 0.79. So, I got my mole fraction of oxygen that is equal to 0.21. I got my mole fraction of neon that is equal to 0.79. Now, I have to apply this to find out the partial pressure of oxygen as well as partial pressure of neon. So, first let us calculate the partial pressure of oxygen. So, partial pressure of oxygen is equal to mole fraction of oxygen into Pt. So, that's equal to mole fraction of oxygen is 0.21 into Pt is 25 bar. So, that's equal to 5.25 bar. So, that's the partial pressure of oxygen. Then, partial pressure of neon gas that is equal to mole fraction of neon gas into Pt. So, mole fraction of neon gas is 0.79 into Pt. Pt is 25 bar. That is equal to 19.75 bar. So, that's the partial pressure of neon. So, among 25 bar of total pressure, the partial pressure of oxygen is 5.25 bar and partial pressure of neon is 19.75 bar. If you sum it up P1 plus P2 anta calculate madidre, if sum madidre nodi 5.25 19.75 madidre, it will be 25 bar itself. Andre ik tane gotaitu PT total pressure is the sum of partial pressure of each individual gases. And partial pressure of oxygen 5.25 bar plus partial pressure of neon 19.75 bar madre barado 25 bar, that is nothing but your Pt. So this is about your first numerical based upon Dalton's law of partial pressures. Next let us move on to the second problem. So the second numerical based upon your Dalton's law of partial pressure goes like this. A cylinder filled with 48 grams of methane and 16 grams of helium. So, you have a cylinder which is filled with two gases. One is methane and the other one is helium. They are non-reacting in nature. So, 48 grams of methane is there and 16 grams of helium is there. Whose total volume is 2 liters. That is, the cylinder volume is 2 liters. And temperature is equal to 300 Kelvin. That is, the cylinder is kept at a temperature of 300 Kelvin. Calculate the mole fraction of each gas. Yeradu gases do mole fraction calculate maadbeku. Its partial pressures. Yeradu gases do partial pressures calculate maadbeku. And you have to calculate the total pressure. So, first one calculate maadana. That is, calculate the mole fraction of all gases. That is, both the gases. So, given that mass of methane, it is equal to 48 grams. And mass of helium, it is equal to 16 grams. So, first you have to calculate the number of moles. Mole fraction calculate maadodukku munche you have to calculate the number of moles. So, number of moles calculate maadidre. Number of moles of methane, it is equal to mass by molecular mass. That is equal to mass is 48 grams divided by the molecular mass of methane. Carbon is 12. Hydrogen is 4, that is 1 and 2, 4 atoms, so it is 4. So, the molecular mass of methane is 16 grams. So, the number of moles of methane is equal to 3 moles. Adhe tara number of moles of helium, that is equal to mass of helium divided by molecular mass of helium. Mass is given, it is 16 grams divided by the molecular mass of helium. As I have told you in your previous problem, noble gases are atomic gases. Hence, atomic mass itself, you have to take it here. So, atomic mass of helium is 4 grams.
4 grams, that is equal to 4 moles.
So this is the number of moles of methane, this is the number of moles of helium. Now calculate the mole fraction of methane. Methane is equal to number of moles of methane divided by number of moles of methane plus number of moles of helium. That is equal to number of moles of methane is 3. So 3 divided by 3 plus 4, that is equal to 3 divided by 7, that is equal to 0.428. So that is the mole fraction of methane. So we know that mole fraction of methane plus mole fraction of helium, it is equal to 1. So hence mole fraction of helium, it is equal to 1 minus mole fraction of methane, that is equal to 1 minus 0.428, that is equal to 0.572. So that's the mole fraction of helium. So the first question is complete. We have calculated the mole fraction of methane, that is equal to 0.428. We have calculated the mole fraction of helium, that is equal to 0.572. The next question we have to solve here, it is mole fraction aito. Mole fraction is completed. The next question is, you have to calculate the partial pressure of each gas. You have to calculate the partial pressure. So partial pressure formula, you know, partial pressure is equal to mole fraction that we have found out, ide namatra, into PT, that is into total pressure. But in the question, you can observe that total pressure is not given. Kottila, total pressure kottila. So hagagi, you have to calculate total pressure, and that is even one of the question, calculate the total pressure. So total pressure calculate madmele, you can calculate the partial pressure of each gas. So the next thing we have to move on to is, you have to calculate total pressure, aamele adrinda partial pressure na calculate madbeku. When we saw the derivation of formula for partial pressure derive madavaga, we saw formula for PT, that is total pressure, that is PT is equal to N1 plus N2 into RT by V. E formula nodadvi. What is PT anta nodadaga? During the derivation of partial pressure equations from Dalton's law, nodadvi PT is equal to N1 plus N2 into RT by V anta nodadvi. So PT calculate maadbeku. N1 andre ili you can take it as the number of moles of methane. N2 you can take it as number of moles of helium. R, it's a constant. Temperature is given. Kottidare temperature 300 Kelvin anta. Volume is also given, it is 2 liters. So volume is given, temperature is given. So yeno volume 2 liters. Temperature gottu 300 Kelvin. R value is a constant. R value is a constant. Yen constant togobeku andre illi nodi liter Kelvin nallide. Liter matte Kelvin nallide. Calculate maadbekagirad eno pressure. So hagagi R value you have to take it as 0.082 liter atmosphere per mole per Kelvin. So since temperature is considered in Kelvin, volume is considered in liter, and you have to calculate the pressure. So you have to take the R value, yerad R value ide. So adrali you have to take the value R is equal to 0.082 liter atmosphere per mole per Kelvin. N1 eno, N1 is number of moles of methane, that is 3. N2, number of moles of helium, that is equal to 4. So this is the number of moles of methane, this is the number of moles of helium. Now we calculate maadidivi ik tane. So you have to calculate PT now. So PT is equal to 3 plus 4 into 0.082 into 300 divided by 2. That is equal to 86.1 atmosphere. That is the total pressure exerted by your methane gas and your helium gas. So atmosphere is the unit. Heg atmosphere aitu anta tagondre idrudu unit mole. Mole per mole cancel agutte. Idrudu unit idrudu unit to Kelvin. Kelvin per Kelvin cancel agutte. Idrudu unit liter. Liter illi denominator alide illi numerator alide cancel agutte. So ulkolod bande it is atmosphere. So the total pressure is 86.1 atmosphere. So ega partial pressure calculate madana. So partial pressure of methane, it it is equal to mole fraction of methane into PT. So what is the mole fraction of methane? We have calculated it. It is 0.428 into total pressure is 86.1. So partial pressure of methane, it is equal to 36.850 atmosphere. So that's the partial pressure of methane. Ide tarano partial pressure of helium calculate maadabodu. Partial pressure of helium is equal to mole fraction of helium into PT. Atarano maadabodu. Athwa we know that partial pressure of methane plus partial pressure of helium, it is equal to PT. Hango calculate maadabodu. So you can use this formula, same thing, or you can directly use this formula, that is partial pressure of methane plus partial pressure of helium, it is equal to total pressure. Ad bekadru maadabodu. So the other method nan use maartini, you can use this method also to calculate the partial pressure of helium. So mole fraction of helium gottu, into PT maadidre you get the partial pressure of helium. So we know that P total is equal to partial pressure of methane plus partial pressure of helium. It namu gottu from Dalton's law. PT calculate maadidivi 86.1 atmosphere. That is equal to partial pressure of methane calculate maadidivi, that is 36.85 plus partial pressure of helium. So partial pressure of helium, it is equal to 86.1 minus 36.85 atmosphere agat. So that is equal to the partial pressure of helium, it is equal to 49.25 atmosphere. So partial pressure of methane is 36.850 atmosphere. Partial pressure of helium is 49.25 atmosphere. And the total pressure, it is equal to 86.1 atmosphere. So mole fractions ha calculate maadidvi. Mole fraction of methane is 0.428. Mole fraction of helium, it is 0.571. So these are the three parameters asked in your question. Mole fraction of each gas, partial pressure of each gas, and the total pressure, that is equal to 86.1 atmosphere. So this is about the numericals based upon Dalton's law. Next, let us move on to the kinetic theory of gases, that is kinetic molecular theory of gases. So as the name itself tells that this is a theory which has some postulates put forth which describes the behavior of gases. So how is a gas? So what is it made up of? So adru bage helo anta kelu postulates ide. So this is the theory put forth to describe the behavior of gases. So this theory, again tagontidiva, the postulates of this theory put forth is holds good for your ideal gases. That is, there are two types of gases anta nodidivi, ideal gas and real gas. So this theory, all the postulates in this theory is valid for 100% valid for your ideal gases, and partially it is applicable for your real gases. So yen postulates tagoltivo a postulates, so all the postulates holds good for your ideal gases and some postulates holds good for your real gases. So holds good for ideal gas is to 100%, partially holds good for real gases. So there are a lot of postulates of this theory. So you can also call it as assumptions of this theory. So assumptions with respect to the behavior of a gas. So the first postulate of kinetic gas theory is all gases are made up of particles called as molecules, and all these molecules of a similar gas, of a same gas, have similar properties like size, mass, shape, etc. So very importantly, it is either made up of tiny particles, that is molecules. They have same size, similar size. That is, the molecules of a same gas have similar size, mass, shape, etc. These molecules of gases, are separated by long distances. That is, they are separated by long gap. Hence, if you consider the volume of gaseous molecules, it is very, very negligible when compared to the volume of the total gas. Andre, say for example, you have a box, one box there. Adrali I release a gas, ondu gas na release maadtini. So our gas in maadutte, it occupies the volume of that chamber. So you have a chamber, I release a gas into this, ondu gas na release maadtini. Yen maadutte gas molecules, it occupies the whole chamber, idi chamber na occupy maadutte. So now what is the volume of the gas? This whole chamber is the volume of the gas. If I catch all these gas molecules, all gas molecules no, nano catch maadi. If I trap it into a box, So this is the actual volume of the gaseous molecules. So this is the volume of the gas, This is the volume of the gaseous molecules. Ellanu trap maadi one box olaga hakadre ishte box olagade adu hidiyutte. Adhe aa gas na nanu release maadidre into a chamber athwa into this room anta tagondre it occupies the whole volume. Hagage en heltivi andre since the distance between the gaseous molecules is very large athwa they are separated by long distances, the volume of the gaseous molecules is very tiny when compared to the volume of the gas. Gas in a volume compare madidre gaseous molecules in a volume tumba tumbane kadime negligible anta heltare. It is very very tiny. That is because of this long distances between the gaseous molecules. The postulate goes like this: since the gaseous molecules are separated by large distances, that is one molecule go inon molecule go, they are separated by large distance irodrinda the volume of gaseous molecule agle helidnala ella gas molecules nu trap madidre adu yen a volume occupy madutto, that is very negligible when compared to the total volume of the gas. Adu total volume occupy madkolutto adu compare madidre aa gaseous molecule na trap maadi hididre aa molecules na volume it is very very negligible. So this is the next postulate. So since in the second postulate it is assumed that the gaseous molecules are separated by large distance, andre gaseous molecules madhya distance is very large anta consider madradrinda, third postulate alli en heltare antandre the intermolecular force between these gaseous molecules, since they are far apart, ee gaseous molecules far apart irodrinda according to second postulate the intermolecular force of attraction between the gaseous molecules is zero anta heltare, andre there is no intermolecular force of attraction between the gaseous molecules anta heltare third postulate alli, which is wrong with respect to real gases. That is real gases alli there is a interaction between, that is weak van der Waals force of attraction between the gaseous molecules, but kinetic gas theory alli enna heltare since the molecules are separated by large distance there is no intermolecular force of attraction between the gases anta heltare. So that's about your third postulate. Since according to second postulate the gaseous molecules are far apart, the intermolecular force of attraction andre aa molecules madhya yavade tarada intermolecular force of attraction illa, that is the intermolecular force of attraction between gaseous molecules is absent, which is right for ideal gas but which is wrong for your real gas. Real gases alli there is a force of attraction, so hence this postulate holds good only for your ideal gas and this doesn't hold good for your real gases. The next postulate is about the movement of gaseous molecules. So the gaseous molecules move in all directions, but in a straight line, with different velocity, bere bere velocities alli gaseous molecules move aagtirutte in different directions with different velocities but in a straight line. So during such motions they collide with each other, ee gaseous molecules en madutte they collide with each other as well as they collide with the walls of the container. So yen container alli gas tagondirthivo aa walls melano they collide. The important thing here you have to observe is the gaseous molecules, although they move in different directions, although they move with different velocities, but they move in straight lines. So the postulate goes like this: the gaseous molecules moves in different directions, bere bere directions alli different velocities, bere bere velocities alli move agutte but in a straight line, they always move in a straight line. During such movements they collide with each other, ondukondu they collide as well as they collide with the walls of the container, containerina walls jothegu collisions aagtave. The next postulate is due to this collisions of your gaseous molecules with the container's walls, containerina walls jothe collisions aagorodrinda they create a pressure inside the container which is called as the pressure of the gas. So this collisions with the container walls creates the pressure and that is called as the pressure of the gas, and the pressure of the gas that is due to the collisions of the gaseous molecules with the container, is directly proportional to the number of gaseous molecules. Yest gaseous molecules ide anadru mele directly proportional agutte, that is your pressure of the gas. So the fifth postulate goes like this. So the collisions of the gaseous molecules with the container walls, container in a walls with the collision agodrinda, there is a pressure created, and this pressure created is directly proportional to the number of gas molecules inside that container. The sixth postulate is about, again about collisions of gaseous molecules. The collisions of gaseous molecules here are completely elastic collisions. So what do you mean by elastic collisions, Andre? Elastic collision is nothing but the collision, during the collision or after the collision, the energy of the gaseous molecule is conserved. The momentum of the gaseous molecules is conserved. That is, after the collision and before the collision, in energy irutho, it is remain as it is. Energy is conserved. Athva yen helbodu? There is no loss in energy, neither loss in momentum of the molecules, gaseous molecules. So such type of collisions are called as elastic collisions. The collisions which are undergoing here inside the container is completely elastic, which means that gas molecules in a momentum agli, energy agli, there is no loss. Munche collision ing munche yesh titto, collision admelo, momentum mathe energy is as it is conserved in the healthy. Such type of collisions are called as elastic collisions. The last postulate of your kinetic theory is about the kinetic energy of your gaseous molecules. That is, the kinetic energy of these gaseous molecules, obviously they are moving means it has some energy, and that is with respect to your kinetic energy. And that kinetic energy is directly proportional, that is, it is depending only upon your absolute temperature. That is, kinetic energy of gaseous molecules, those are wandering here and there, that is, they are moving here and there, is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Since the gaseous molecules are moving, the energy virtue with movement is nothing but kinetic energy. So all gaseous molecules possess kinetic energy, and this kinetic energy of the gaseous molecules is purely depending only upon the absolute temperature and not on any of the other properties of your gases, like your nature of gas, type of gas, etc. Adru mele yavadru mele depend agala. It is purely depending upon the absolute temperature. So this is about the assumptions and postulates, assumptions or postulates of your kinetic gas theory. So there are a lot of postulates which have been concised into 7 important postulates. Assumptions which holds good for your ideal gases and partially holds good for your real gases. So this is about your kinetic theory of gases.